Kaneichi Wagwan, everybody. A short tutorial on finding the arguments of complex numbers. Now, you might want to watch my tutorial on the argand diagram first, because I'm going to use them to find arguments. So here's a very straightforward instruction to do. You're told to find the argument of 2 plus 2 root 3i. The best way to find an argument is actually know what an argument means and know how to find it from an argand diagram. Now, I have done a tutorial on the argand diagram, so you should know the real component goes along the horizontal axis, the imaginary component across. Now, this is just a sketch to help me, so I'm simply going to mark a point. Scale is irrelevant here, and that is my complex number. The real component here is 2, and the imaginary component, which is on the vertical axis, is 2 root 3. What's the argument of a complex number? It's the angle it makes with the real axis. So I'm looking for that angle there. Now this is a straightforward right-angled triangle, and you have the opposite and the adjacent side. So you should know, therefore, that the tangent, I'm just going to call it theta for now, the tangent of theta equals the opposite over the adjacent. And yes, I did choose these numbers on purpose, so that's root 3. So theta equals the arc tangent, my pen's gone all over the place, of root 3. And that, of course, equals pi upon 3. So what is the argument of this number? Well, let's write our answer very explicitly. The argument of 2 plus 2 root 3i equals pi upon 3. Finding the argument is as straightforward as trigonometry, but let me show you two examples that might catch you out. So again, we just launch in, find the argument, and we're given a number here. We go straight to the argand diagram. The scales are relevant, I'm just putting a number here. What's important is that the real component is root 3, and the imaginary component is minus I, so this has a length of 1. Now, if I simply perform a bit of trigonometry to find this angle theta, then I see that the tangent of theta equals the opposite over the adjacent, so 1 upon root 3. Theta equals the arctangent, that's the inverse tangent of 1 upon root 3, which equals pi upon 6. But that's not the argument. Why is that not the argument? Have a think to yourself. You probably know already, and you're just doing a little bit of extra revision. The reason for it is that these angles have to be measured in a certain direction. From the real axis, we measure this way round is positive, and this way round is negative. Okay, so clockwise is negative, anti-clockwise is positive. Just a little bit to think through, but it's something you need to remember. So we can see which way round we've gone here. And so the argument of root 3 minus I, you should all be able to see, is minus pi upon 6. Exactly the same as before, simple bit of trig, but then we just need to remember which way round the angle goes. So I'm going to show you one more example. Maybe pause the video and see if you get the right answer, and then press play to watch it. I've just written the question slightly differently here, but I've given you a complex number and asked you to find the argument of it. So here's our argand diagram. The real component this time is minus 3, so we're over here, and the imaginary component is 3. So I'm up here on the diagram. Now if we just consider the values, of course, then we've come 3 backwards and gone 3 up. And so the argument, and this is where you just need to be careful, is given by this angle here. Remember, we're measuring this way round from the real axis. Now, you can obviously find ways around this, and if you use formula correctly, then you don't need to do the next stage, but I just always consider the right-angle triangle. I've been doing right-angle triangles since primary school. Maybe not arctangents, admittedly. So I'm going to work out theta first, and it's enough to say that I'm just going to skip a stage here. Theta is the arctangent, and on that right-angle triangle is the arctangent of 3 upon 3, which equals the arctangent of 1. It's pi upon 4. But you can clearly see, therefore, that the argument of z that I want is going to equal, well, 180 degrees, which is pi, take away a quarter of pi. And so my final answer that I'm going to give, the argument of z that I have been asked to find equals 3/4 of pi, or 3 pi upon 4. So a couple of things we need to remember. Let me just recap before I leave you. So the argument of z simply is the angle that the line of z makes with the axis. We go around this way, it will be positive. Remember that if we have a complex number right the way over here, the angle is this one here, measured from the axis, and in that case it will be negative. One final thing is that usually the argument of z is between minus pi and pi. And that simply means if you had a line over here that we'd gone round all the way round twice, there'd be no need to consider that. We'd simply measure this angle here. One last little detail, but hopefully you've got the idea. You can now find the arguments of z without discussion and without argument. If you found this video useful, please share it with the world, put it on your Facebook page, tweet about it. Your mates will think you're doing them a great favour if you help them do well in their exams. And I want to help you do well in your exams. So get in touch with me through Facebook or Twitter, and you can stay updated with everything I'm doing. And I'm only doing it to help you. So if you need help, get in touch, and I'll do the things you need me to do. Good luck, guys. You're going to do absolutely fantastic.